Tonight, of course, at 9:30 here on the DSTV channel 404. Do not miss it. Staying in the Mountain Kingdom, as Justice Dikgang Moseneke continue to persuade stakeholders in Lesotho to implement SADC reforms programs, the opposition has announced that the leaders who've been in exile in South Africa have agreed to return to Lesotho. Lesotho has experienced political tensions after the opposition lost power during the June 2016 election. One of the main opposition leaders and the former Deputy Prime Minister in Lesotho, Mothejoa Metsing, who's also the leader of LCD, joins me now in studio to take this discussion. Feda Mohlompe, good afternoon to you. Thank you so much for coming through.
Good afternoon.
So I suppose the question here is, are you going back to Lesotho?
Yes, I'm going back to Lesotho on the 25th. But first of all, allow me to thank you for hosting me and also greet your viewers. So the answer to your question is yes, I'll be going back to Lesotho on the 25th.
But why specifically on the 25th? I mean, there are so many discussions that are currently taking place. As it is now, as I speak to you, Justice Dikgang Moseneke is having a meeting with some of the leaders. Are you not afraid that you may lose on some important decisions that have been taken there?
No, I'm not going to lose, because actually I am representing a political party. I'm a leader of a political party. If I'm going there, I'll be getting the mandate from the party. So in the same manner, there are other people that can be deployed from the party, and they have been given the mandate to represent us. So I have a confidence in them.
Also, you do have a representation there.
Yes,
now. All right.
Yes, yes.
Okay, so you're returning on the 25th. That is, of course, you and other opposition leaders in Lesotho. Mm. What are the conditions in that meeting?
No, you remember, in fact, last year you hosted me here, and one of the reason, or the main reason that I left Lesotho, it was because of the security concerns. I was fearing for my life. That has always been the most contentious issue. Now, as you have rightly pointed out, the former Chief Justice Ndadede Dikgang Moseneke and his team is there, and they have brokered a deal between the government and the opposition in parliament and other stakeholders as well, that the government must ensure my security. And even SADC itself, really, as the guarantor of that agreement, is going to actually see to it that the government abide by the undertaking or by the agreement that they have done.
But what makes you so certain that your life will no longer be in danger and intimidating when you go back? Because previously, when the current president of South Africa, who's the former deputy president and was deployed in Lesotho as a mediator, some of the opposition leaders were saying they don't have trust in SADC anymore. So what gives you the confidence this time around that things will change for the better?
Noma, thank you very much. First of all, the deal that has been reached, it was brokered by SADC, and I personally still have confidence in SADC. And point number two, I must indicate that I am not completely certain that my security will be guaranteed. But unfortunately, this comes with the territory. I am a leader. The process that is unfolding in Lesotho and needs me to be there also as the representative of the people. But my hope, I hope and pray that the government will ensure and abide by the agreement. I've got guarantees from SADC.
So talks have been there previously.
Yes.
Have you ever sat down with the Prime Minister Ndate Tom Thabane now and have this conversation that we're having now on your safety or issues around your security?
As of now, it is Chief Justice Moseneke who has been doing this, and my colleagues, other political parties, other leaders of political parties in parliament.
But what are
who
they
have
saying?
Been doing the
what bidding. Sense are they getting from the government?
No, the government is giving a guarantee that they will definitely give me the security, and I'm taking their word. But I'm saying it is the responsibility. I'm having a responsibility to my people and to my country.
Yeah.
So I have to go back trusting that the government will definitely take, ensure that they respect their part of the bargain. And I've got a guarantee from Dade Moseneke. I have no reason really to doubt SADC. And also to doubt the government. I hope what they mean, what they say, it is what they mean.
Part of the reason why I'm asking you as to whether you've had this conversation with Ntate Thabane is there are reports that are saying you've agreed to return to Lesotho on one condition, that you resume your previous position as the Deputy Prime Minister. Is that what you want?
Oh, no. That actually, remember when you hosted me, I indicated to you that one of the things that the government has done is to take away my privileges that are granted to me by the law, my privileges as a former Deputy Prime Minister. So one of the things that we have been asking for is that the government must respect the law and I must be recognized as the former Deputy
Prime
Minister.
So are you getting your benefits back? Is that what you're saying?
Not yet.
But is it part of the agreement?
It is a process. It is actually working in process. They have just now agreed to provide me with security. They also have made, there was a press conference that was made in Lesotho by the Minister of Foreign Affairs indicating that they have now received a legal opinion to the effect that I qualify to be treated as a former Deputy Prime Minister. But they have not yet come to me to give me those privileges. Yeah. Some of the privileges I'm already getting, I'm already receiving, but others are still not coming forth.
Are you worried that they're not coming forth as it is now?
I hope.
Is it something that worries you? More so the issue around security, because as you said when you hosted you last year, you were very worried that your life was a threat.
Yes. You know, what I can only indicate at this stage is that we are at the very beginning. There was a conflict between myself and the current government, and now we have SADC intervening. I have a responsibility on my side that if the government is moving from their original position, I also, even though I'm not that fully, happy that the government will respect that they're part of the bargain, but also
What makes you unhappy? Let's just talk about that part where you say you're not
unfortunately,
fully happy.
Unfortunately, even after the agreement was signed, high-ranking officials from government, some of them were saying that they are not going to respect the agreement, and other people now are challenging that agreement in the courts of law. But the government is saying no, they are still committed to the agreement, and on my part, that is why I'm saying that I have to show responsibility. Remember that international community, SADC, many people are doing their best to ensure that they are assisting us. But at the end of the day, it is us, the leaders of Lesotho, who must be in the front row of this actually problem solving.
All right.
Reforms.
Quick one.
Yes.
We've run out of time, but I need to put this through to you. You're going back to being a member of parliament in Lesotho from the 25th, are we likely to see coalitions formed? Are we likely to see floor crossing happening, which may lead to Lesotho going to the elections again?
No, I know that from all sides, from the government, from ourselves, everybody feels that this current government...
I'm talking about the opposition party because we were not happy with certain things before this happened.
We are saying that whatever happens, we think that we must not go back to elections. Mm. But that we have a law and that people are free to do what they would like to do in parliament, people will still be free to do that. But what we have to guard against is to ensure that anything that is happening in parliament, it doesn't take us back to elections just 2 years down the line, because that in itself it's creating a lot of instability in the country. Remember now, within 6 years I think, or within 5 years, we have gone to elections 2 times.
Just on a personal level, we do know that there were some charges preferred against you. There were issues around the monies that were apparently deposited into your bank account illegally. Do you not see it fit now to go stand trial for such charges in order to clear your name moving forward in that
thing? Thank you very much. No, I have been always indicating that those charges were politically motivated, and that is what has been agreed with the current agreement that we have, that we need first of all to go through the process of reforms and all those pending charges will be suspended, part of the agreement.
But I think society is taking the matter to court tomorrow.
Yes, there are those who are taking the matter to court. But I don't think really, you remember, even previously, when we were in government, there were some challenges that were made to the decisions that were made between government and SADC. But SADC has always prevailed, because SADC had always said that, no, as a country, you need to abide by the agreement of SADC. Because when SADC now came in, you cannot rely only on your local laws, and it happened before. So I still believe that even though they are making challenges, because it happened before, we think that if government is genuine, those cases will not really fly.
Time constraints. Oh. There's so much to get to, but I'm afraid we've run out of time. Thank you so much for coming through, and I suppose we'll keep in touch to see what happens on the 25th.
No, thank you very much for hosting me.
All right. Many thanks there to Ntate Mothejoa Metsing. He, of course, is the former Deputy Prime Minister in Lesotho, and he's the leader of the opposition party, LCD, saying that all opposition leaders who are in exile in South Africa are going back to Lesotho on the 25th of this month.